Focus In with Teddi Florence, your introduction to the movers and shakers in Maryland and the surrounding states. And now, here's your host, Teddi Florence, with this week's guest.
Hi, welcome to Focus In Maryland with Teddi, and thank you for clicking in and visiting us on our website. Today on the show, we have Reverend Willie Wingo, who is the owner, the founder of everything of the Power Magazine.
Thank you.
Thank you so much for being here, and I appreciate it.
I'm very glad to be here, and I thank God for you allowing me to come and to interview, and I'm very excited about this.
Great. Now tell me, what was your vision to come up with this magazine? What was the idea, the thought process?
I've had a lot of practice saying that, because we've been publishing for 15 years, and about 15 years ago at my first church, we had a lady, God bless her soul, she has gone on to be with the Lord, but she would get up and read the announcements. Mm-hmm. And as she started reading the announcements, she'd fumble with her glasses and the announcements and get out of place and where she was in the reading of the announcements. And so I was sitting there thinking, this is during worship now, of course, mm-hmm. and I was sitting there thinking, there's got to be a better way for the churches in the area to tell one another what's happening. So I said, what if everybody would put their announcements together in a magazine or in a booklet form, and then we would distribute that booklet throughout the churches in the Harford and Cecil County area. And so that was the beginning of Power Magazine, and the churches chipped right in and saw the vision. And the rest is history, as they say.
Great. And so it was 15 years?
15 years, celebrated April of this past year, 2005.
Okay. So was it difficult to get this started, or were people reluctant, or did anybody else ever try something like this?
Well,
or is there another magazine out there like this?
We're the number one magazine in the African American community in Baltimore and the surrounding area, and that includes Washington, D.C. The difficulty factor, I would say this. When I started, I did not own a computer. I could not type. I had no knowledge of what a magazine or publishing was all about. But when God gives you a vision, He equips you for that vision. And inside of me was all these gifts just waiting to explode for such a time as this. And so I went and got a computer, I taught myself how to type, and the support came from all areas, family, my wife, friends I knew, everybody just grabbed a hold of the vision. I was passionate about it, and because of that, we were able to sustain ourselves, move forward slowly, mm-hmm. slowly, because believe me, what you see here in color, it was black and white, and it was much cruder than this,
okay.
but it was more than what was expected at the time.
Mm-hmm. So you're the editor, you are just everything.
I'm everything, but I'm nothing without the staff that I have now around me. For 11 years, we worked out of our home doing the magazine. I'd sell advertising and in the daytime, and at night I'd come in and I'd do the layout of the magazine on the computer. So we outgrew our den, and my wife was about to kill me because I'd taken over all the space. And I kept telling her, I need a secretary. And she said, well, don't even think about her. And because we needed somebody to work a full-time job, because we never knew how things were going to be in the beginning as far as the magazine was concerned. But the Lord blessed, and one day we were able to get office space, and then God sent me people. And right now I'm surrounded by some of the best people in the world. They helped me do this, and I sleep a lot better at night.
Oh, well, that's good. Well, it's a wonderful magazine. I mean, I had the opportunity to look at this magazine for the first time last year.
Okay.
And you see, it's another year, and
yes.
it's in my hands again.
Yes, yes,
so,
yes.
So again, I'm directed some kind of connection to this magazine.
Yes. People...
That's powerful.
People call me all the time. They've got magazines going back 4, 5, 6 years. Even longer. Some of them tell me they even have all of my magazines.
Mm-hmm.
I wish I knew that, how to find those people now.
Mm-hmm.
But the magazine is something that people hold on to for some reason. Even though the information is that we put out every month is current,
mm-hmm.
People like to hold on to magazines. I guess, and maybe just keep them for historical purposes.
You know what would be nice, and I just had a thought that came to me.
Share it, please.
Is if you could get all 15 or all the volumes and just cut the corner off and just put it in a frame.
You're the second, third, fourth, maybe fifth person that's told me that. I got to do it. I got to do that.
Yeah.
And some of people have said even blow it up and put it on a wall. I got a wall. You got to come to my office. But I've got a wall in my office that idea that you just said. So I guess this is a confirmation.
I tell you.
Okay.
It's power, isn't it?
Okay.
Let's divert a little bit.
Okay.
Let's talk about the world issues. What's going on? What are your views, or do you think that there's a message in all of what's happening around the world?
Well, there's so many different issues that's happening in the world today. And I mean, we live in such a time of turmoil, especially if, you know, being relevant, what's happening over in the Middle East, what just happened in London. So it's a lot of controversy in regards to what different leaders, what their agendas are, and how we should handle it. But my view is this: God is in charge. And with God in charge, I can sleep at night knowing that He's in control, knowing that I'm doing the purpose that He's put me here for, and I'm just trying to make the world a better place.
What do you think about prayer in the schools? And
well, I think prayer should be in the school. When I came up, prayer was in the school.
Right.
And there's so
much controversy around that. Plus, you know, the Pledge of Allegiance and all of that stuff.
Yeah, well, we seem to take away the rights of those who desire to have prayer, desire to pledge allegiance, for the minority, in my sense, who feel as though they're being victim because they have to participate in the prayer or the pledge to allegiance. But I think this is America. We've got God in everything almost that we do, whether it's the flag, our money, and we were founded on biblical principles.
Right.
So what's the problem?
Right. I guess it's everybody's, you got so many different views.
Right.
You know, and I was brought up with prayer in school and the Pledge of Allegiance and all that stuff too. And and I just think that the more that type of stuff is taken away, the more crumbling we're going to see of the world and people's values and morals. We're continuing to lose it every day.
Well, when you look at society and see how society is crumbling right now, you look at our youth, you look at the issues they're dealing with, the drugs, the crime, prayer, in my opinion, would definitely be something that could turn that around.
Do you have a church?
Yes, I pastor a church.
Okay.
It's in Harford County. It's Chestnut Grove AME Church. I've been pastoring for the last 15 years. I've been at this particular church for about 3 years. I'm an AME, and our bishop is Bishop Richardson.
Okay, great. What kind of outreach are you doing to the communities? Your surrounding communities where you pastor?
Where I pastor, we outreach to the prisons. We're very concerned with that. We've helped those that are elderly in nursing homes. We have a small congregation. It's in a rural area. And so we just try and help people with food baskets at Christmas time, make sure that we help the young people. We have several people that are going to, we have a scholarship fund that we give to the young people. We plan trips, Christian activities, just trying to enrich it and nurture our young people.
Well, that's all I have.
Okay.
And I certainly do appreciate, again, you being here and taking the time out of your schedule to be with us.
Well, I'm so glad to be here and be with you. And I just thank God for this opportunity. And it's just wonderful being able to showcase what Power is doing and the ministry. I kind of consider it a ministry. And thank you for having me. And thank you for allowing me to have a little prayer with you before we got started. And remember, God's got the power.
Oh, most definitely.
Okay.
Now, if anybody wants to get in contact with you for anything, maybe if they just need someone to talk to, they want to come to your church, how can they get in touch with you?
Well, our office is in downtown Baltimore, 828 East Baltimore Street. Our phone number is 410-539-8886. We're on the web, www.thepowermag.com. Please feel free to call us. And there's one thing I must mention. We have a page where we call it our Prayer of Salvation in the magazine, and five people have given their life to Christ through reading that prayer and giving us a call.
So, oh, that's powerful.
That's powerful.
Thank you again so
You're
much.
You're welcome. God bless you. Thank you.
And thank you for visiting us today. Have a great day.